guys for coming.
Wow. This is awesome.
So, Who Really Left You is a project about self-abandonment. So, in all the different ways it can show up. A lot of it's about the ways it can show up in a relationship. But it can show up in addiction, and it can show up in any time that you put something else before what you really need or to escape from you. And I want to take a minute and give a lot of special thanks to Billy. Not to be a lot of cheesiness up here, but he's really helped me so much in getting this thing self-published and all the little breakdowns and stressful moments, because I just picked a date and gave myself 2 months to figure out how to publish it and to get it all together, because I just felt like I needed to finish this project as I'm starting new ones. And I'm gonna start now. I have starlight in my eyes, a tigress roar that flows from my heart, hips like mirrored crescent moons, and hair like baby's breath. But when he told me my eyes were muddy, I believed him. When he stomped on my heart's voice, I let him. When he told me I take up too much space, my hips swallowed me. When my asymmetrical haircut wasn't feminine to him anymore, I cried like a baby fighting sleep, like my inner child wanting to be. I cried oceans because I believed him. When he abandoned me in this brokenness, I left myself behind as well. I was trying to go with him. Why? When I cry because he left me, I'm also crying because I left myself. I begged him to water me, to bathe me in his sunlight, or to let me go. I could have left at any time, but my freedom slowly became his discretion. Out of all the people to leave behind, why would you abandon yourself? Home. It's not a place, nor a person. Home is in your heart, and only you can move away. Don't ever make a man your brick and mortar.